If you are in your 30s or 40s and struggling with joint pain, you might be wondering, is this normal for my age? Am I getting old, or is this a sign of a disease? In this video, I will tell you everything about joint pain, the red flags that you should never ignore if you are in your 30s or 40s, and then when it's time to call a doctor. I am Dr. Diana Garnita, a double board certified rheumatologist with over 15 years of experience helping people with joint pain and autoimmune diseases. First, let's address a common question. Is it normal to have joint pain in your 30s or 40s? And the short answer is sometimes. It is normal to have some degree of joint pain at the end of the day if you do too much typing, and because that's a repetitive motion that can affect your hands. Or it is normal to have some back pain after lifting boxes all day long. Or if you had a recent sprain or a strain after running, then yes, you can have some joint pain. Or if you play a lot of intense sports, lots of running, jumping, or high impact exercises, then in your 30s or 40s, you might notice that you can have some joint pain because you start developing some wear and tear. Now, let me take a short break and tell you about something very interesting. If you are a woman and if you are in your 30s or 40s, then you probably notice some degree of joint pain and even more stiffness before your menstrual cycle. Did you notice that? I have many patients that will ask me, why is this happening? And the answer is because of your fluctuation in the hormones level, especially estrogen. Yes, because estrogen plays a big role in reducing inflammation and maintaining your joints healthy. Before and during menstruation, estrogen levels drops, which can increase inflammation and will increase the sensitivity in your joints. Plus, your body releases prostaglandins during the menstruation time, which may cause uterine contraction, and they can also contribute to generalized pain and discomfort, including your joints. If you have an inflammatory arthritis like rheumatoid arthritis or psoriatic arthritis, you may notice that these symptoms are even worse during menstruation. However, this so-called normal pain should go away pretty quickly with rest, with ice, or taking an over-the-counter medication like ibuprofen, but if you take it just once in a while. Now let's move on and answer another big question. When is joint pain not normal in your 30s or 40s? If the pain lingers and even worsens, if you start developing swelling, stiffness, and many other symptoms like rashes, fevers, or fatigue, if you need to take ibuprofen every single day, then it is something wrong, because this is not normal. And I call these signs red flags. They should draw your attention and you should start looking for an arthritis doctor like me, because I'm a rheumatologist and I help people with joint pain to figure out what's the cause and how to treat it. So let's talk more about these red flags. First, persistent pain. If you have joint pain or back pain that doesn't improve after a few weeks, then this is not normal. If you have morning stiffness, if you wake up in a lot of stiffness in your hands, in your feet, in your lower back, that will last more than 1 hour, pay attention. If you have swelling or if you have redness in one or multiple joints, if they become red and warm, this is a sign of inflammation. If you have many other symptoms like low-grade fevers, severe fatigue, rashes, thickening of the skin, chest pain, shortness of breath, this could be actually additional clues that might be saying that you are dealing with an autoimmune disease like rheumatoid arthritis or lupus or scleroderma. Now, let me tell you that there are some autoimmune diseases that can start in your 30s. And I will point towards a couple of very important things that you have to pay attention to. If you are a woman, if you are after a pregnancy, if you have a significant family history of an autoimmune disease, then pay attention, because you do have an increased risk. If your mother or your sister had rheumatoid arthritis or lupus, then your risk to develop these diseases is double, if not triple. And now let me talk to you even in more depth about diseases, autoimmune diseases that can cause arthritis in your 30s or in your 40s. Rheumatoid arthritis. This is a type of arthritis that tends to start in the small joints of the hands and feet, like the small and the big knuckles, but also can affect the wrist. I cannot tell you how many patients I have seen misdiagnosed with carpal tunnel syndrome because they had pain and numbness in both wrists. Some of the patients had even carpal tunnel surgeries, and after many failed surgeries, they were sent to me to be evaluated. So if you have pain and stiffness in both wrists, if you have tingling and numbness in both of your hands, this might be a sign of rheumatoid arthritis. There are other causes, but rheumatoid arthritis is a big possibility. Another thing to pay attention is pain and stiffness in both hands, both feet, both knees, or both ankles at the same time, because that's unusual, correct? Then if this stiffness is mainly present in the mornings, if it will last more than 1 hour and it tends to get better as the day goes by, then pay attention and go to see a rheumatologist. Psoriatic arthritis. If you have psoriasis, if you were officially diagnosed with psoriasis, then pay attention if you develop joint pain. However, let me tell you about a common situation that I see in my practice. Most of these patients, that they have a rash, sometimes on the scalp, on the ears, behind the elbows or knees, and sometimes in more sensitive areas like genital areas. And the rash is red and scaly, it may cause some itchiness. The rash can come and go, and many times people will buy a steroid cream over the counter, they will treat that themselves, and because of that, they don't even tell the doctors. They don't even think to mention it to the doctors, and they don't know that this rash can be psoriasis. And if they have the rash and they go to be seen and they get diagnosed by a dermatologist, they don't even think to tell that doctor, the skin doctor, about the fact that they might have joint pain. And then when they have the joint pain, they will mention it to their primary care physician, and most of the time they will be sent to an orthopedic doctor. And there they might get an injection, they might get other treatments, but during those appointments, they don't even think to mention that they have a rash or they have psoriasis. So that's why the diagnosis of psoriatic arthritis is many times delayed. And as a rheumatologist in my practice, I do things differently. I review the medical records of each patient before they come in. Patients also complete an extensive health questionnaire that will ask them about rashes, about psoriasis. And when they see me, they spend 1 hour just with the doctor. Not with the nurse, not with anybody else. They spend the time with me. And in this way, I have more time to understand much better what is happening to them and how their disease progressed over time. And I cannot tell you how amazed I am to see that many patients will not be diagnosed or will be diagnosed very late with psoriatic arthritis. And there is another thing that happens in people with psoriatic arthritis. Because there are no laboratory tests, like in rheumatoid arthritis, to diagnose psoriatic arthritis, then many times patients do not get the diagnosis. Because even the markers of inflammation can be normal. And that's why, if you don't have an experience as a doctor to diagnose this disease, if you don't have enough time to spend with the patients, if you don't listen to the patient's history, then if you look at the labs and you see the labs normal, you might miss this diagnosis very easily. Psoriatic arthritis can affect multiple joints, like the hands, the wrists, the ankles, but it doesn't respect the symmetrical and bilateral pattern like rheumatoid arthritis. And people with psoriatic arthritis can have one joint affected in one hand, and they might have the wrist or the knee on the other side of the body affected. Plus, patients with psoriatic arthritis can have their tendons affected, which can cause dactylitis or saucy digits. They can have episodes of tendinitis, like tendinitis of the elbows, the Achilles tendon, and even plantar fasciitis. And something even more interesting, do you know that psoriatic arthritis can cause inflammation of your eyes? We call this uveitis, and this is frequently seen in patients with psoriatic arthritis. Ankylosing spondylitis. ankylosing spondylitis, or AS. It is an autoimmune disease or a type of arthritis that affects the spine. And if you are in your 30s or 40s and you start experiencing back pain, upper or lower back pain, sometimes in the buttock area, if you have severe and prolonged morning stiffness that will last for more than 1 hour, but the stiffness is better when you start moving, then think about ankylosing spondylitis. This disease is commonly diagnosed before the age of 45 and can affect both men and women. What is interesting to find out is that many times people think that if you are a woman, then you cannot have AS. Plus, many females will delay their diagnosis because many times they think their back pain comes from something else, from moving the furniture, because they were pregnant, because they were carrying their kids in their arms. So they will find many explanations for their joint pain or their back pain. And to make things even more complicated, many women will have their labs normal, including their markers of inflammation. So that's why the diagnosis of AS or ankylosing spondylitis is even more challenging to be done in females. Many people think that if you have the HLA-B27, you have AS. But HLA-B27 is a laboratory test, which is frequently associated with AS. But this is important. Not all the people that have a positive HLA-B27 will develop the disease. Yes, if you have the HLA-B27 positive, then you are at higher risk, but there is no guarantee that you will develop AS. Now, can you have AS or ankylosing spondylitis if the HLA-B27 is negative? And the answer is yes. When I diagnose someone with AS, I look at the whole picture and not only at the laboratory test. I listen to the patient's story, I do labs, I do an MRI of the back, because the most reliable test to show you inflammation in the spine are the MRIs and not X-rays. X-rays will only show you if you have advanced disease with fusion of the spine, but it will not show active signs of inflammation. Now let's talk about another frequent autoimmune disease that primarily affects women, but it can also affect men. And I'm talking about lupus, or systemic lupus erythematosus. This systemic autoimmune disease can affect joints and other organs like the skin, the lungs, the heart, the brain, the kidneys, and even blood counts. And lupus is a very complex disease. It has many signs, and the signs and symptoms can vary from patient to patient. Some patients might have pain in the small joints of the hands, which can look like red, swollen, inflamed, and they could mimic rheumatoid arthritis. But there are also patients that might present with Raynaud's phenomenon, which is that phenomenon that will show like changing colors of your hands when you expose your hands to cold weather. There are also patients that will present with the classic rash, the butterfly rash that will sit on the nose and on the cheeks. Or there are patients that will present with fatigue, with chest pain, with shortness of breath, with hair loss, with ulcerations in the mouth, with enlarged lymph nodes, with protein or blood in the urine, or even blood clots, or miscarriages. So if you are a woman, pay attention to these signs. Pay attention if you develop confusion or psychosis, because lupus is tricky and can affect all the organs. Now, the big question is, when should you call a rheumatologist if you have joint pain? And my advice is, if you are experiencing pain that will last more than 2 to 4 weeks without any improvement, if you have multiple joints hurting at the same time, if you have swelling, if you have redness, if you see worms in your joints, if you have multiple other signs like we discussed, low-grade fevers, unexplained weight loss, extreme fatigue, enlarged lymph nodes, rashes, hair loss, then you should call a rheumatologist like me. We have the clinical skills to understand if you have normal joint pain or if you have an autoimmune disease or an inflammatory arthritis caused by an autoimmune disease. And now that you know what's normal and what is not when it comes to joint pain in your 30s or 40s, you should learn more about the most common tests that we use to diagnose autoimmune diseases. Because if you don't know what tests are needed, then you will keep suffering for many years that will come with a disease that is undiagnosed. And I talk about all of this here.